Hi everyone. If you mix for TV, you have to mix according to the EBU R128 specs here in Europe. Otherwise the TV station won't accept your audio. Sounds complicated, but it isn't. In this video, I'll show you how to make your mix TV ready. The first thing you need is an EBU R128 meter. There are some free options. The Uhlin Loudness Meter 2 is probably one of the best free options out there. Whatever software you use, this plugin will most likely work. For example, it works in Cubase, Pro Tools, Final Cut, Audition, Logic, all of them. Right now, I'm using it in Pro Tools with this video.
When the world is your playground, you want to achieve optimal use of your machine fleet. Detect issues remotely.
This video was created for IODA by Loepzuiver, and I was asked to do the sound design and the mix for it. It's actually a video of 1.5 minutes, but let's pretend for now that this part is the whole video and this is going to be aired on TV.
IODA saves downtime and enables optimal use of machines. IODA, efficient machine monitoring.
So, we'll pretend that that's the whole commercial. Let's make the video a little smaller. And put it here. And open up the Uhlin meter. Don't be thrown off by all the graphs and the numbers and the meters here, because we're only going to focus on this and this. Audio metering can become quite complex. The standard meters you will find in audio or video software are usually peak meters, like this one over here. What they do is they show you the loudest peak of the audio, but that doesn't say anything about how loud it sounds. Let me quickly show you this. I've got two bits of audio here. If I play back this one, we can see the maximum level over here.
Based on this data, we advise you about the optimization of your powertrain.
So that's minus 6 dB. But this audio is also at minus 6 dB.
Based on this data, we advise you about the optimization of your powertrain.
But it sounds much louder, because in this example I just used some tools like compressors and limiters to make it seem louder to the ear. But a peak meter doesn't detect that. A loudness meter, like the Uhlin, cannot be fooled like that. It will detect that this one is louder than this one. And this is why TV stations started using this kind of metering, to make sure every program has the same perceived loudness level. So, how to make your mix TV ready? The first thing you do is just make a great mix. Don't be bothered with how loud it sounds, just make it sound great. After that, you put the Uhlin meter on the master fader. It should be the last plugin on that fader after all other plugins. Then the first thing you do is select the EBU R128 preset. Now I'll quickly hit play, so you can see some values here. LU stands for loudness units, and FS stands for full scale. And one loudness unit is the equivalent of 1 dB. dBs and what full scale means are quite a complex topic. Not something for this video, but in the tutorial Practical Audio Theory on audiokickstart.com, you can learn more about this if you want. For making your mix TV ready, it's enough to know that your mix should be at minus 23 here, and it shouldn't exceed minus 1 over here, so minus 10.3 would be okay. So how to get there? Well, we need an integrated value, so for that we need to play back the whole commercial first.
IODA saves downtime and enables optimal use of machines. IODA, efficient machine monitoring.
Now we see that it has an integrated value of minus 20.2 LUFS. So that is 2.8 LUFS too loud. The true peak level is fine, we're way below minus 1 dB. So now all we have to do is reduce the overall level of the commercial by 2.8 dB, because 1 LU equals 1 dB. I've got a fader here that is called Full Mix, and with this I control the volume of the whole mix. And then on the master fader I've put my Uhlin plugin. So now I'm just gonna reduce the level by 2.8 dB. There we go. You can see it here. And now we're going to play back the whole commercial again.
IODA saves downtime and enables optimal use of machines. IODA, efficient machine monitoring.
And now we're at minus 23. The true peak level is still fine, it's way below minus 1, so that's good as well. This doesn't have to be exactly minus 23, by the way. If it's anywhere between 22.5 and 23.5, you're good. Now, all you have to do is render it to a 24-bit, 48 kilohertz wave file, interleaved, which means stereo, and then your mix is ready. That's it. Thanks for watching. For more tutorials, go to audiokickstart.com.